Hello everyone, welcome back for another workshop on English language paper for SPM. Today we're going to focus on paper 4, which is a paper on listening. So let's look at the format for paper 4 listening. For paper 4 listening, the total time allocated for this paper is around 40 minutes. The total marks for paper 4 is 30 marks. There are 4 parts in this paper. Most of the tasks in this paper consists of multiple choice questions or MCQ. There's one part that requires students to write short answers. The weight of this question is 25%. The task type for part 1 is multiple choice question. This part consists of 7 questions. The task type for part 2 is multiple choice question. And this part consists of 8 questions. For part 3, the task type is multiple choice question. And the total number of question for this part is 5. For the last part, part 4, students require to write short answers. And this part consists of 10 questions. Now we're going to talk about the phases for the listening paper. There are 3 major phases in the listening paper. Phase 1, pre-listening. In pre-listening, students are required to read the questions. Students are given a certain amount of time to read the questions. Students are advised to use the time properly and read the questions. Phase 2, the first listening. In the first listening, students are required to listen for specific information based on the question they have read just now. For phase 3, the second listening, students are required to find missing information or the answer they have missed just now. If the student already found the answer, students can double check their answer in the second listening. The overall tips for paper 4. Number 1. Always read the question before you listen. One of the difficulties in this paper is that you are not just listening, but reading and writing the answer at the same time. So one simple tip is to read the question before you listen, so that you know what you are listening for. The second tip. Please do not leave the answering to the end. Sometimes the candidates leave the answering part to the end, thinking that they will remember what they heard. In my experience, this almost never works. There is a lot of information. You are under stress and, most importantly, after each listening, you should be moving on to the next set of questions. Tips number three. Always read and listen to the instruction carefully. This is because this will give you information such as how many questions you need to answer. Tips number four. Always underline the keywords in the question. Most of the time, the keywords are consist of nouns and verbs. Please do not feel worried or panic if you miss the answer the first time. It is because you can always hear the recording twice. The next tip is do not lose attention. If you did not hear some words and pass over some question, do not worry. Leave them blank and focus on the actual part. Review those questions at the end of the section. Otherwise, you will only miss more questions and tackle in the recording. The next tip is please do not leave any blank answer at the end. There are two reasons for this. Firstly, your guess may well be correct, particularly if it is a multiple choice question. Secondly, there is a danger if you leave a blank and you write the answer in the wrong box on the answer sheet, and that can be a disaster. The last tip will be transfer the answer accurately. At the end of the listening task, you will be given times for transferring your answer into the answer sheet. And quite often, students get confused in the numberings. As you write down your answer, check that they fit into the correct number spaced. In other words, make sure that the answer for question 7 go into the space number 7. Now we're going to talk about part 1. Question 1 to 7. Here is some extra tips for part 1. Number 1. Always read ahead the question before the listening start. If you think you don't have enough time to read through all the question and the answer option, please focus on the question first. Always underline the keywords in the questions. During the listening, do not listen for the keywords, but rather for the specific information. Always jot down important information during the listening. Now we're going to look at the question in part 1. In part 1, you will hear people talking in 7 different situations. For each question in part 1, there will be 1 situation. Let's try to do question in part 1. You have 20 seconds to read the questions.
One. You hear a woman talking about a job interview.
I had an interview for a part-time job in a department store today. The weather was terrible and I was a bit stressed when I arrived. When I met the interviewer, the first thing he said to me was, "Windy day." And I said without thinking, "No, Jane Green." I felt such a fool because I thought he had said Wendy Day and was getting my name wrong. It was not a good start. I realised that they really want people who are looking for a career in the store. And as I only want a temporary job, I doubt they'll hire me. Oh well, at least my friends will laugh when I tell them about it. I had an interview for a part-time job in a department store today. The weather was terrible and I was a bit stressed when I arrived. When I met the interviewer, the first thing he said to me was, "Windy day." And I said without thinking, "No, Jane Green." I felt such a fool because I thought he had said, "Wendy Day," and was getting my name wrong. It was not a good start. I realised that they really want people who are looking for a career in the store. And as I only want a temporary job, I doubt they'll hire me. Oh well, at least my friends will laugh when I tell them about it.
2. You hear two people talking about an old friend.
Guess who I saw when I was out shopping?
Who?
Your old friend Mary.
Oh well, she always loved shopping.
No, she was working in that big new toy shop.
What? You're joking, surely? She was so ambitious. She wanted to go to university and have a serious career.
I know, it's a bit of a shock, but she seemed quite happy to be working there. Guess who I saw when I was out shopping?
Who?
Your old friend Mary.
Oh well, she always loved shopping.
No, she was working in that big new toy shop.
What? You're joking, surely? She was so ambitious. She wanted to go to university and have a serious career.
I know, it's a bit of a shock, but she seemed quite happy to be working there.
3. You hear a woman talking.
Since I retired from my job last year, I've been having the time of my life. I'm doing all those things I never had time to do when I was working, and I've even taken up chess. I still find time to keep up with my old friends from work. We meet up every weekend, so I don't miss out on any of the office gossip. I'm busier than I've ever been, and I can't say I ever get bored. I volunteer at the hospital once a week, and I've got a long list of things I still want to do. Next year, I plan to go on a luxury cruise. Since I retired from my job last year, I've been having the time of my life. I'm doing all those things I never had time to do when I was working, and I've even taken up chess. I still find time to keep up with my old friends from work. We meet up every weekend, so I don't miss out on any of the office gossip. I'm busier than I've ever been, and I can't say I ever get bored. I volunteer at the hospital once a week, and I've got a long list of things I still want to do. Next year, I plan to go on a luxury cruise.
4. You hear two people talking about a job.
So if you're a nurse, that means you have to work nights, I suppose. That must be exhausting.
No, I'm used to it. I don't mind, actually, because the hospital is really quiet at night. Also, nurses only work nights for short periods.
So do you sleep during the day?
Well, of course. I just turn off my phone, close my bedroom door, and tell the family to keep quiet.
So if you're a nurse, that means you have to work nights, I suppose. That must be exhausting.
No, I'm used to it. I don't mind, actually, because the hospital is really quiet at night. Also, nurses only work nights for short periods.
So do you sleep during the day?
Well, of course. I just turn off my phone, close my bedroom door, and tell the family to keep quiet.
5. You hear a woman talking.
I run my own business, which can be exhausting. I work long hours and employ 20 people. As the boss, I have to be responsible for everything, and I can't just go off on holiday whenever I like. I can't remember the last time I took more than a day off. The work is very satisfying, though, and I love the fact that the business is getting bigger every year. This is the first time we've made a big profit, and I'll need to hire some more staff soon. My son is keen to take over the company, but I don't think I will ever quit. I run my own business, which can be exhausting. I work long hours and employ 20 people. As the boss, I have to be responsible for everything, and I can't just go off on holiday whenever I like. I can't remember the last time I took more than a day off. The work is very satisfying, though, and I love the fact that the business is getting bigger every year. This is the first time we've made a big profit, and I'll need to hire some more staff soon. My son is keen to take over the company, but I don't think I will ever quit.
6. You hear a man talking.
I got another letter from a company today saying that they couldn't offer me the job that I'd applied for. For every job, they get hundreds of applicants. I must have applied for over 60 jobs since I left university. At first, I was upset, but you don't get anywhere by sitting around feeling sorry for yourself. I know if I just keep trying, I'll get the career I want. I'm not going to give up now. I got another letter from a company today saying that they couldn't offer me the job that I'd applied for. For every job, they get hundreds of applicants. I must have applied for over 60 jobs since I left university. At first, I was upset, but you don't get anywhere by sitting around feeling sorry for yourself. I know if I just keep trying, I'll get the career I want. I'm not going to give up now.
7. You hear a woman and a man talking.
You know, that pizza restaurant has offered me a Saturday job, and I think I'll take it.
Oh, I wouldn't if I were you. You know, I've heard they don't pay very well, and you'll smell of pizza when you come home. Also, you'll never be able to go away at weekends if you work on Saturdays.
You've got a point, but I need to earn some money.
Well, why don't you apply for evenings in the local supermarket? A friend of mine works there, and she says you can tell them which evenings you're available, and you don't have to work every weekend.
You know, that pizza restaurant has offered me a Saturday job, and I think I'll take it.
Oh, I wouldn't if I were you. You know, I've heard they don't pay very well, and you'll smell of pizza when you come home. Also, you'll never be able to go away at weekends if you work on Saturdays.
You've got a point, but I need to earn some money.
Well, why don't you apply for evenings in the local supermarket? A friend of mine works there, and she says you can tell them which evenings you're available, and you don't have to work every weekend.
Now we are going to check the answers from question 1 to 7. Question number 1. The question asks, how did the woman feel after talking to the interviewer? Okay, so from the transcript, we can see that the woman actually mentioned that she feels like a fool. So why does the woman feel like a fool? Because the interviewer asked her about something, but she answers something else. So in this situation, we can conclude that the woman actually feel embarrassed. So the answer is C. Now we're going to discuss on question 2. Question 2 asks about how does the woman feel when he heard the news about her old friend. Okay, so from the expression here, What, you are joking, Shirley? So we know that the woman actually feels shocked. We cannot say, from the expression, we cannot say the woman was actually quite happy or hopeful. Okay, so it is clear that the woman feels shocked. So the answer is shocked. For question 3. Question 3 asks about how is her life since the retirement. Okay, so let's look at the answer option. Does the woman feel bored? No, it's not mentioned in the transcript. Is she enjoying herself? Yes, we can see that after she was retired from her job last year, she was having a time of her life. Okay, we can see over here. Okay, so what about C? She has nothing to do. Okay, does the transcript or the audio that you listened just now mention that she has nothing to do? No. Actually, you can see here the woman has a lot of things to do. For example, like what? Take up chess. Okay? Keep up with his old friends from work. Also mentioned here, she was busy. So C is wrong. A is wrong. Okay, so the answer here is B. Now we're going to look at question 4. The question 4 asks about how does a woman feel about her job? We look at option A. Does a woman feel the job is exhausting? So we can see here from the expression that I am used to it. It means that the woman doesn't think the job is exhausting as she was used to the job. Okay, so we look at B. Is something getting used to? Does a woman need to get used to the job? No, because she's already used to the job. So A is wrong. B is wrong. So we only have C. She is used to it. So the answer is very clear here. The answer is C. Now we're going to look at question 5. In question 5, the question asks, how does a woman describe her job? We look at option A. It is exhausting. Okay, so from the expression here, I run my own business, which can be exhausting. So it shows that the woman thinks that her job is exhausting. What about B? She can go for holiday. For the expression over here, I cannot just go off on holiday whenever I like. It shows that the woman cannot go for holiday whenever she likes. What about C? It's not very satisfying. So for the expression, the word is very satisfied, it means that the woman actually quite enjoyed her job. So it means that the woman is satisfied with her job. Okay, so C is wrong, B is wrong, so A is correct. So the answer is A. Question 6. Question 6 asks about how does the man feel after he received the letter? So we look at the very end of the transcript here. The man mentioned that I am not going to give up. Okay, so we can see here in the end, the man actually feel very hopeful. Okay, so the answer for question number 6 is hopeful. The last question in part 1, question 7. What was the woman's recommendation to the man? So, for the question, we know that the woman had made a recommendation. So, what was the recommendation? So, we can see here, the woman asked, why don't you apply for the evenings in the local supermarket? So we can see here that the woman actually wants the man to work in the local supermarket. So the answer for question number 7 is C. Now we're going to look at part 2. Question 8 to 15. Here is some extra tips for part 2. Tips number 1. Always read ahead the question before the listening start. Tips number 2. Do not spend too much time on one question. And question number 3. Please do not feel panic when you cannot answer the question. Here are some example questions in part 2. You have 20 seconds to read the questions.
Quiet, please. Right, okay. So today I'm going to give you some advice to help you prepare for the exams next week. So make some notes as I'm talking, please. Everybody ready? Now, while you're studying, eat food that gives you energy. Don't be tempted to eat sweets or drink cola. Now, sugar won't help you study, but fruit and cereals will. Apples, actually, are especially good. Find a comfortable place with plenty of light when you study, but not too comfortable or you'll fall asleep. Try and keep a positive mind. It is easier to study when you are positive and relaxed. Now, if you start feeling anxious, have a little break. Go out for a stroll around the block. Don't try to learn everything. There isn't time. Just choose the important things, the things that will get you the most points in an exam. Now, if you aren't sure about this, ask me. First, learn the main ideas and don't worry too much about the details. If you have time, you can come back later and read the details. Make notes of these key points and read them. Then cover them up and try to remember all the points. Now, it might be boring, but repetition helps you to remember. Use past exam papers to study. They will help you understand what kind of questions come up. There are plenty of past exam papers in the library. You can photocopy them and take them home. Take regular breaks while you're studying. A 5-minute break every half hour is usually enough. Get some fresh air and stretch your arms and legs. Drink a glass of water too. It's important to keep hydrated. And last but not least, good luck. I'm sure you'll all do your best. Quiet, please. Right, okay. So today I'm going to give you some advice to help you prepare for the exams next week. So make some notes as I'm talking, please. Everybody ready? Now, while you're studying, eat food that gives you energy. Don't be tempted to eat sweets or drink cola. Now, sugar won't help you study, but fruit and cereals will. Apples, actually, are especially good. Find a comfortable place with plenty of light when you study, but not too comfortable, or you'll fall asleep. Try and keep a positive mind. It is easier to study when you are positive and relaxed. Now, if you start feeling anxious, have a little break. Go out for a stroll around the block. Don't try to learn everything. There isn't time. Just choose the important things, the things that will get you the most points in an exam. Now, if you aren't sure about this, ask me. First, learn the main ideas and don't worry too much about the details. If you have time, you can come back later and read the details. Make notes of these key points and read them. Then cover them up and try to remember all the points. Now, it might be boring, but repetition helps you to remember. Use past exam papers to study. They will help you understand what kind of questions come up. There are plenty of past exam papers in the library. You can photocopy them and take them home. Take regular breaks while you're studying. A 5-minute break every half hour is usually enough. Get some fresh air and stretch your arms and legs. Drink a glass of water too. It's important to keep hydrated. And last but not least, good luck. I'm sure you'll all do your best.
Now we are going to discuss on the answers in part two. Let's look at question number 8. The question asks, the teacher wants the student to do what at the very beginning? So we try to go through the transcript together. Okay? So, morning everyone, quiet please, right? Okay, so today I'm going to give you some advice to help you prepare for the examination. So make some notes as I am talking. So what we can see here is that the teacher wants the student to take notes. Okay, so let's check the answers. Option A, take notes after she has finished talking. Is it after she finished talking, the student take notes? No. B, take notes while she is speaking. Yes. Okay. C, forget about taking notes. So the correct answer for question A is B. Question number 9. The teacher suggests eating what? Okay. So we look at the transcript. Now while you are studying, eat food that gives you energy. So don't be tempted to eat sweet or drink cola. Sugar won't help you study, but fruit and cereal will. So what are the foods that have been recommended by the teacher? We look at the answers options. So A, sugary snack. No, the teacher said that the sugar will not help you study. So A is wrong. Only apples. Is it only apples? We can see here the teachers mentioned about fruits and cereals. Okay, so it's not just about apples. So B is incorrect. So fruit and cereals. Is it correct? Yes, because it's mentioned here already. Fruit and cereal will help you study. So the answer for question number 9 is C. Now we're going to look at question number 10. The teacher suggests Finding a study place with a lot of what? So let's go over the transcript. Find a comfortable place with plenty of light when you study. So here it is quite clear already that the teacher recommends the student to find a place with a lot of light. Okay, so the answer for question number 10 is A. Question 11. If the student feels stressed, they should do what? Okay, so we look at the transcript. Try and keep a positive mind. It is easier to study when you are positive and relaxed. Now, if you start feeling anxious, have a little break. Go out for a stroll around the block. What do we mean by go out for a stroll? A stroll means that you go for a walk. So it's very clear that question 11, the answer is B, go out for a walk. Question number 12. Students are advised to A, select the important things to learn, or B, read through everything once, or C, make notes about every topic. So we can see here, do not try to learn everything. Just choose the important things, the things that will get you the most points in the exam. So we can see here, the teacher advised the student to only select the important things to learn. So the answer here is A. Now we look at question number 13. The teachers understand that repeating things can be. Okay, so here is the transcript. If you have time, you can come back later and read the details. Make notes of these key points and read them. Then cover them up and try to remember all the points. Now, it might be boring, but repetitive helps you to remember. So we know that the teacher said that repeating things can be quite boring. So which word here had a similar meaning with boring? Yes, the answer is uninteresting. So the answer is B. Question 14. Student can do past exam paper. So let's look at the transcript. Use past exam paper to study. They will help you understand what kind of question come up. There are plenty of past exam paper in the library. You can photostat them and take them home. So look at the answer option here. So student can do past year question paper in the library only. Is it mentioned here? No, it's not mentioned here. So B, at home. They can do the question paper at home if they take photocopy. Is it mentioned here? Yes, it's mentioned here already. You can photocopy them and then take them home. So the answer for question number 14 is B. Question number 15. The teacher recommends a break of 5 minutes every. So we look at the transcript. Take regular breaks while you are studying. 5 minutes break every half hour is usually enough. So we look at the answer option. A, hour, no. 2 hour, no. 30 minutes. Is it 30 minutes equals to half hour? Yes. So the answer for question number 15 is C. Now we move on to part 3, question 16 to question 20. Here are some extra tips for part 3. Tips number 1, read ahead the option list or the answers list. Underline the unit words. Later, we're going to look at some examples of unique words. Pay attention to which speaker is speaking. There are a total of 5 speakers in part 3. Make sure that there's no repetitive answers. Here is some examples on the question in part 3. In part 3, you will hear 5 people talking about their oldest friends. For question 16 to 20, choose from the list A to G what each speaker says. Use the letter only once. There are 2 extra letters which you do not need to use. So let's go over to the list. A. I no longer meet my friends. B. My friend and I were not from the traditional family. As you can see here in the list A and B, I, my friend, is the word that always repeat. No longer meet traditional family. Those are considered as unique words. So please underline this word when you go through the list. Now we're going to do question in part 3. You have 20 seconds to read the options.
Speaker 1.
Old friends are wonderful, a bit like the best family. Mine come from the neighbourhood where I've lived all my life. My oldest friend is a woman that I met when we were both at primary school. We both come from single-parent families and always got on very well. We helped each other when life was difficult. Even when I thought my world was falling apart, my friend was there to lend a hand. She really is very important to me, and I know I couldn't get by without her.
Speaker 2.
I try very hard to keep in touch with my oldest friend, Joanna, who lives in Australia. We met while we were still studying at university. When we got our first jobs, we bought a house together in London. It was perfect because she was always so cheerful and never grumbled, even if she was sick and tired of her work. We both did our fair share in the house and rarely argued. Then she started going out with a young Australian colleague, and a year later she moved to Australia. We still have a chat every week, but I miss her company.
Speaker 3.
My oldest friend really is that. He is about 50 years older than me, and a bit like the grandfather that I never had. He's a university professor who I met while I was studying art. I find him really interesting, and we always have amazing discussions. We argue too, but we both enjoy a good argument. He gives me good advice in my career as an artist, but often criticizes my work too. He always says what he thinks, which is something I admire in him.
Speaker 4.
I met my oldest friend when my children were small. We both had school-age children, and one day we just started talking at the school gates. We discovered that our children were in the same class and also got on well. Both our families were new to the neighbourhood. It was fun to get together with another mother who understood my problems. Our children grew up together and soon made more friends, and we also found that the local people were not unfriendly at all. Now our children have grown up and we're both in our 50s. We still enjoy each other's company.
Speaker 5.
My oldest friend and I were once very close, like brothers. We met when we played music together in a band after we'd just left school. We argued a lot and the band fell apart. We didn't speak to each other for a whole year. Later I realized that life is too short to fight over small things, and now we are good friends again. We are both musicians now, and when we get together, we usually laugh about our past arguments. We are both older and calmer now. We're like brothers again, and often go away on holiday together with our families when we get a chance.
Speaker 1.
Old friends are wonderful, a bit like the best family. Mine come from the neighbourhood where I've lived all my life. My oldest friend is a woman that I met when we were both at primary school. We both come from single-parent families and always got on very well. We helped each other when life was difficult. Even when I thought my world was falling apart, my friend was there to lend a hand. She really is very important to me, and I know I couldn't get by without her.
Speaker 2.
I try very hard to keep in touch with my oldest friend, Joanna, who lives in Australia. We met while we were still studying at university. When we got our first jobs, we bought a house together in London. It was perfect because she was always so cheerful and never grumbled, even if she was sick and tired of her work. We both did our fair share in the house and rarely argued. Then she started going out with a young Australian colleague, and a year later she moved to Australia. We still have a chat every week, but I miss her company.
Speaker 3.
My oldest friend really is that. He is about 50 years older than me, and a bit like the grandfather that I never had. He's a university professor who I met while I was studying art. I find him really interesting, and we always have amazing discussions. We argue too, but we both enjoy a good argument. He gives me good advice in my career as an artist, but often criticizes my work too. He always says what he thinks, which is something I admire in him.
Speaker 4.
I met my oldest friend when my children were small. We both had school-age children, and one day we just started talking at the school gates. We discovered that our children were in the same class and also got on well. Both our families were new to the neighbourhood. It was fun to get together with another mother who understood my problems. Our children grew up together and soon made more friends, and we also found that the local people were not unfriendly at all. Now our children have grown up, and we're both in our 50s. We still enjoy each other's company.
Speaker 5.
My oldest friend and I were once very close, like brothers. We met when we played music together in a band after we'd just left school. We argued a lot and the band fell apart. We didn't speak to each other for a whole year. Later I realized that life is too short to fight over small things, and now we are good friends again. We are both musicians now, and when we get together, we usually laugh about our past arguments. We are both older and calmer now. We're like brothers again, and often go away on holiday together with our families when we get a chance.
Now we're going to check the answers in part 3. Speaker 1, he talks about he and his friend are from a single-parent family. Single-parent family is not a traditional family. So, B is the answer for question 16. Speaker 2 had a very hard time keeping in touch with his oldest friend, Joanna, because she had moved to Australia. They still have a chat every week, but she misses her company. So this means that Speaker 2 is no longer seeing her friend. So the answer for question 17 is A. Speaker 3 talks about his oldest friend who is 50 years old older than him. So this means that this Speaker 3 has a friend from a different generation. So the answer for question number 18 is F. Now we're going to look at Speaker 4. Speaker 4 talks a lot about her children. So, which of the answer option here mentioned about children? Yes, D. My friend and I had children at the same school. So question 19, the answer is D. Speaker 5. Speaker 5 mentioned that he and his friend had a lot of arguments. So, A to G, which of the option here mentioned about argument? Yes, C. My friend and I used to fall out a lot. Fall out means a lot of arguments. So the answer for question 20 is C. Part 4. Question 21 to question 30. Here are some of the extra tips for part 4. For part 4, you must listen and read the instruction. This is in order to check the word limit for the answers you're going to write. Always use the word that you hear. And after you finish, fill in the blank. Make sure that you check the spellings and grammar. In part 4, you are required to fill in the missing information in each number space. So, make sure that you always read or listen to the instruction before you do part 4. In this part, you will hear a person talking about climate change, and your answer must not more than one word. Let's do part 4 now. You have 20 seconds to study the question.
The planet's climate has constantly been changing over thousands of years. The global average temperature today is about 15 degrees Celsius. Scientists are worried that the planet is warming faster than ever before. The 20 warmest years on record have been in the past 22 years, according to the World Meteorological Organization. If this trend continues, temperatures may rise by 3 to 5 degrees Celsius by 2100. Scientists say we should try and stop this trend and not allow the average global temperature to rise more than 1.5 degrees. But even a 2 degrees Celsius rise would be bad for us all. Now, half a degree doesn't sound like much, but it could make a big difference to the planet. A 2 degrees Celsius rise would mean that all the coral reefs would disappear, but a 1.5 degrees Celsius rise means that there would still be some. Also, 18% of the insects on Earth will disappear if the temperature goes up by 2 degrees Celsius, compared to 6% disappearing at 1.5 degrees Celsius. 37% of people will be affected by dangerous heat waves at 2 degrees Celsius. That's twice the number compared to at a 1.5 degrees Celsius rise. Whether it's coral reefs, crops, floods or the survival of species, scientists say everyone and everything is far better off in a world that limits the rise to 1.5 degrees Celsius. So, what can we do? Scientists say that carbon will have to be sucked out of the air by machines and stored underground and that these devices exist already. They also say that billions of trees will have to be planted. People should buy less meat. Of all the foods we eat, beef has the biggest impact on climate change because it produces a high amount of greenhouse gases. Also, someone suggested not buying new clothes too often, because the fashion industry is a major source of the greenhouse gases that are overheating the planet. And, of course, using transport that doesn't burn fossil fuels, like electric cars. It's even better to walk or ride a bike. The planet's climate has constantly been changing over thousands of years. The global average temperature today is about 15 degrees Celsius. Scientists are worried that the planet is warming faster than ever before. The 20 warmest years on record have been in the past 22 years, according to the World Meteorological Organization. If this trend continues, temperatures may rise by 3 to 5 degrees Celsius by 2100. Scientists say we should try and stop this trend and not allow the average global temperature to rise more than 1.5 degrees. But even a 2 degrees Celsius rise would be bad for us all. Now, half a degree doesn't sound like much, but it could make a big difference to the planet. A 2 degrees Celsius rise would mean that all the coral reefs would disappear, but a 1.5 degrees Celsius rise means that there would still be some. Also, 18% of the insects on Earth will disappear if the temperature goes up by 2 degrees Celsius, compared to 6% disappearing at 1.5 degrees Celsius. 37% of people will be affected by dangerous heat waves at 2 degrees Celsius. That's twice the number compared to at a 1.5 degrees Celsius rise. Whether it's coral reefs, crops, floods or the survival of species, scientists say everyone and everything is far better off in a world that limits the rise to 1.5 degrees Celsius. So, what can we do? Scientists say that carbon will have to be sucked out of the air by machines and stored underground and that these devices exist already. They also say that billions of trees will have to be planted. People should buy less meat. Of all the foods we eat, beef has the biggest impact on climate change because it produces a high amount of greenhouse gases. Also, someone suggested not buying new clothes too often, because the fashion industry is a major source of the greenhouse gases that are overheating the planet. And, of course, using transport that doesn't burn fossil fuels, like electric cars. It's even better to walk or ride a bike.
Now let's check the answer for part 4. For question 21. Today, the blank temperature of the planet is about 15 Celsius. So if we study the transcript, it's mentioned here the planet's climate had constantly been changing over thousands of years. The global average temperature today is about 15 Celsius. So the suitable word that we can fill in here is average. Question 22. Scientists think that temperature may rise blank 3 to 5 Celsius by 2100. From the transcript, if this trend continues, temperatures may rise by 3 to 5 Celsius by 2100. So the suitable words here is by. Question 23. Although blank, a degree doesn't seem very much, it could make a big difference. So from the transcript, now half a degree doesn't sound like much. So here the suitable answer for question 23 is half a degree. So the answer is half. Question 24. 80% blank insect on Earth will disappear if the temperature rises by 2 Celsius. From the transcript, also 80% of the insects on Earth will disappear if the temperature goes up by 2 Celsius. So the answer for question 24 is off. Question 25. This is blank to 6% disappearing at 1.5 Celsius. So we study the transcript. Also, 80% of the insect on Earth will disappear if the temperatures go up by 2 Celsius compared to 6% disappearing at 1.5 Celsius. So the suitable word here is compared. Question 26. If there is a 2 Celsius rise, blank, the numbers of people will be affected by heat waves. So let's look at the transcript. 37% of people will be affected by dangerous heat waves at 2 Celsius. That is twice the numbers compared to a 1.5 Celsius rise. So the suitable words here is twice the number of people. Question 37. We'll be in a better situation if we limit the rise blank 1.5 Celsius. Let's look at the transcript. Whether it's a coral reef crop flood or the survival of species, scientists say everyone and everything is far better off in a world that limits the rise to 1.5 Celsius. So we can see here, limit to the rise to 1.5 Celsius. So it means that the answer for question 27 is 2. Question 28. We need to plant blank of trees. So the transcript. So what we can do, scientists says that carbon will have to be sucked out of the air by machines and stored underground, and that these devices exist already. So they are also says that billions of trees will have to be planted. So we are talking about trees. So the answer is billions of trees. Answer for question 28, billion. Question 29, beef production generates a blank amount of greenhouse gases. So the transcript says, people should buy less meat. Of all the food we eat, beef has the biggest impact on climate change because it produces a high amount of greenhouse gases. So the answer for question 29 is high amount of greenhouse gases. The answer is high. Fashion in part 4. The fashion industry is a blank source of greenhouse gases. So let's go over the transcript. Also, someone suggests that not buying new clothes too often because the fashion industry is a major source of greenhouse gases. So we can see here, the word missing here is major. So the answer for question 30 is major. That is the end of our workshop for today. Thank you for listening. And good luck in your SPM.